My name is Amanda Greve, and I am currently a PhD student here at the University of Minnesota. Here in Minnesota, we've recently been doing a lot of work looking at alfalfa, and I'm here to share some of our research with you today. Alfalfa is widely used as a forage for livestock due to its high nutrient content. Compared to grasses, alfalfa is higher in protein, energy, and many of the essential minerals like calcium. For these reasons, alfalfa is one of the most economically important perennial legumes grown throughout the United States. In Minnesota and Wisconsin alone, alfalfa is grown on over 3 million acres. The image that you see here depicts the changes that alfalfa undergoes as it grows from a more immature vegetative stage up to a more mature flowering stage. It has been well established that with increasing maturity comes increasing yield at the expense of forage digestibility. If this yield component is broken down into stem and leaf yield fractions, we can see that the increasing yield is largely a proponent of increases in stem yield, while the leaf yield remains fairly constant over time. As a plant grows, the stems mature and the plant cell walls become more fibrous. This increasing fiber content is necessary to provide the strength and rigidity necessary for a plant to stand upright. However, this increasing fiber deposition is also largely responsible for the subsequent decrease in forage digestibility. The major fiber components deposited into plant cell walls are cellulose, hemicellulose, and lignin. Of these components, lignin is the major factor affecting forage digestibility. Lignin is a complex structural polymer that is deposited into plant cell walls. You can think of lignin as a kind of scaffolding that provides structure and support to the plant as it continues to grow and mature. As an indigestible component of plants, lignin hampers the digestibility and utilization of alfalfa by our livestock animals. In addition, lignin also binds to cellulose and hemicellulose and is a barrier to their digestibility. These negative effects are primarily associated with lignin concentration, as numerous studies have found strong negative correlations between lignin concentrations and fiber digestibility. With such a strong influence on forage digestibility, small decreases in the lignin content of forages can be expected to have a large impact on fiber digestibility. Because of this, recent work in alfalfa breeding has focused on the production of new alfalfa varieties that contain reduced lignin concentrations. Hygest and Harv Extra are two reduced lignin alfalfa varieties that are now becoming commercially available. These reduced lignin alfalfa varieties offer an opportunity to increase the feeding value of alfalfa by improving fiber digestibility and nutrient availability to our livestock. Previous research has shown that small improvements in fiber digestibility can have a significant impact on animal performance. In addition, reduced lignin alfalfa varieties offer an opportunity to provide increased management flexibility by providing a wider harvest window without a subsequent loss in digestibility. However, field evaluations are needed to determine the yield and the forage quality of our reduced lignin alfalfa varieties compared to reference alfalfa varieties under diverse field conditions. To accomplish this, the objectives of our study were to evaluate the yield and the forage nutritive value of reduced lignin alfalfa compared to reference alfalfa varieties when subject to diverse cutting treatments. Alfalfa was seeded in April of 2015 at 4 locations in Minnesota and was harvested throughout the seeding and first production year. Alfalfa varieties included 3 reference varieties, as well as 1 reduced lignin alfalfa variety. These varieties were chosen because they were all Roundup Ready, high-performing alfalfa varieties. Across all of the varieties, a series of cutting treatments were established. Cutting treatments included a variety of harvest intervals ranging from every 30 to every 45 days for a total of either 4 or 5 cuts throughout the growing season. At the time of harvest, alfalfa plots were first hand sampled to determine maturity and forage nutritive value, and then mechanically harvested and weighed to determine yield. The following results will focus on the first production year results only. Results from the seeding year showed similar trends. This first graph shows the seasonal yield results by location based on the various cutting treatments from the first production year. Cumulative forage yields ranged from 6.6 to 9.8 tons per acre, and are comparable to previously reported alfalfa yields within the upper Midwest. Across all locations, yields were greater under the 40-day cutting treatment compared to the 30-day cutting treatment. This demonstrates that extended cutting treatments have potential to reduce the number of cuts per season while still producing equally high or higher yields. This second graph shows the seasonal yield results based on the alfalfa varieties. As a reminder, the reduced lignin variety is 54HVX41. At Becker, yields for reduced lignin alfalfa were lower compared to reference alfalfa varieties. Yields were similar among alfalfa varieties at Rosemont and St. Paul. These results are promising because they demonstrate that reduced lignin alfalfa has the capability to produce equally high yields compared to reference alfalfa varieties when grown under diverse field conditions. The table you see here shows the forage nutritive value results for alfalfa across the various cutting treatments during the first production year. In this table, cutting treatments appear in the leftmost column, followed by the forage nutritive value parameters for crude protein, neutral detergent fiber, acid detergent lignin, and neutral detergent fiber digestibility. For those of you who are not familiar with these terms, neutral detergent fiber, or NDF, is a measure of the fiber concentration of the forage and includes all three of the major fiber components, cellulose, hemicellulose, and lignin. The numbers shown in this table are for the St. Paul location. However, forage nutritive values were very comparable across each location. As anticipated, cutting treatments with shorter harvest intervals resulted in higher forage nutritive values, including increased crude protein, decreased neutral detergent fiber, decreased acid detergent lignin, and increased neutral detergent fiber digestibility compared to those with longer intervals between harvests. This next table shows the forage nutritive value results based on the different alfalfa varieties, which you can see have replaced cutting treatments in the leftmost column. There were no differences in crude protein among alfalfa varieties, with all varieties containing an average of 18% crude protein. Neutral detergent fiber concentrations averaged 42% and also did not differ among alfalfa varieties. On average, reduced lignin alfalfa demonstrated an 8% reduction in acid detergent lignin and a 10% increase in neutral detergent fiber digestibility compared to reference alfalfa varieties. To examine the effects of cutting treatment on alfalfa forage nutritive value, the relative forage quality for each alfalfa variety was averaged over locations and expressed as a function of growing degree days for both the reduced lignin variety, which is shown in the red dashed line, as well as the average of the three reference varieties, which is shown in the blue solid line. As evidenced by the non-overlapping shaded regions, relative forage quality for reduced lignin alfalfa was greater from 772 to 1248 growing degree days, which represents a range of cutting intervals between 28 and 40 days. The increase in relative forage quality observed for reduced lignin alfalfa across a wide range of growing degree days and cutting intervals demonstrates the potential of this new trait to provide increased flexibility for alfalfa growers. Growers could choose to harvest reduced lignin alfalfa at the same time as reference varieties and obtain a more digestible forage, or could harvest reduced lignin alfalfa under a delayed cutting schedule and maintain forage quality across a lengthened harvest window. For example, reduced lignin alfalfa harvested on a 35-day cutting interval showed a 21% increase in yield and only a 3% reduction in relative forage quality compared to reference varieties harvested on a 30-day harvest interval. In conclusion, results from our various cutting treatments showed us that cutting treatments with a wider harvest interval resulted in increased forage yield, while cutting treatments with a shorter harvest interval resulted in increased forage nutritive value. We saw very minimal differences in yield among our alfalfa varieties. The reduced lignin alfalfa variety had similar crude protein and neutral detergent fiber concentrations, reduced lignin concentrations, and increased neutral detergent fiber digestibility and relative forage quality compared to our reference alfalfa varieties. This tells us that if harvested at the same time as reference alfalfa varieties, reduced lignin alfalfa could provide a more highly digestible forage product. If harvested under a delayed cutting schedule, reduced lignin alfalfa could improve forage yields while maintaining forage quality over time. Thank you for listening.